naturally. Myself and Kripaji, whenever we get the chance to take on this series, we will be giving the talk. So it will be a continuation series. Today it will be only the introduction. Okay? So now next slide. So what is the most important desire of human life? Students, anybody, what do you want in life? It's been given here. To lead a
healthy life.
Healthy life. Do you want to live a long life without health or a healthy life?
Healthy life.
Yeah, so but now what are we doing with medicine? We are all living a long life. But with health or without health, most of us? Without health. We are dependent on a lot of medicines. We are getting a lot of diseases. So this course or this series is to help you live a healthy life by using certain techniques, how you live with nature or in sync with nature, so that you live a long life and healthy life. Now, what are the major types of medicine, you know? What are the types of medicine? Homeopathy, good. Then? Western medicine. What's the term for it? Allopathy. And then, what else you know? Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani. So, these are some major forms of medicine. Next slide. So, actually, what is our native medicine? What is like Indian form of medicine called?
Ayurveda
and Siddha, right? But and what is the meaning of allopathy? Does anybody know what is the meaning of allopathy? Actually, allopathy means other medicine or alternative medicine. But now, we make allopathy or the English medicine as the major form of medicine. And we have put all this native medicine like Ayurveda, Siddha, homeopathy in what type of medicine? Alternative medicine. Very paradox, right? Very opposite. Actually, Western medicine is very early. Ayurveda has existed for several centuries. Okay? Siddha has existed for several centuries. But we are now focusing more on westernized medicine, that is allopathy, and we are focusing less on alternative medicine. So this course will change, we'll try to change our views. So this allopathy, it was coined as a term, allopathy, only in 1810. Only in 1810. And the first company manufacturing medicines was founded in 1849. Pfizer, you all would have heard of the vaccine, no, in COVID, Pfizer vaccine. That Pfizer was the first pharmaceutical company which was founded in 1849. And the synthetic drug chloral hydrate was discovered in 1869. It's all very early, not even, you know, just 200 years, 200 plus years. But our forms of medicine have been there for long. And homeopathy was founded in 1796 in Germany. So homeopathy means like with like, which means they stimulate the healing process by giving minute forms of medicine. The same medicine, they will give little by little, so that the body heals on its own. In Western medicine, we don't help body heal, we treat. If you have fever, suppress the fever. If you have headache, suppress the headache. We don't treat the root cause of disease in allopathy. Do we treat the root cause of disease? We just treat only the symptoms. But in our forms of medicine, it's like in Ayurveda, Siddha or the native medicine, we identify the root cause. That is why it might take longer duration for the treatment to take effect. But since the root is addressed, the effects will also be there for a longer time. Now Ayurveda is a Upaveda, which means it is a supplementary Veda. Veda means what? It's like an operating manual. You get operating manual for washing machine, refrigerator, everything you get, your cell phone, everything you get an operating manual, right? How to operate, how, when there is a problem, what to do. Similarly, Vedas are the operating manual for humankind. Like that, Ayurveda is the operating manual for health. Ayurveda is the operating manual for health. And the word Ayurveda is made up of two words. Ayu and Veda. Ayu means just not life, but actually Ayurveda principle is the union of sharira, that is the body, indriya, sense organs, sattva, mind, and atma, the soul. You can be healthy only when your body, what are the sense organs? Eye, ears, skin, nose, mouth, all of those senses, and your soul, your inner soul, all of it should be healthy, then only you can be healthy as a whole. If you are outside healthy but your inner mind is not healthy, again you will not be healthy, right? So Ayurveda focuses on all four aspects. In English medicine, when we give paracetamol for fever, we think about your mental well-being. We just treat the fever, right? If there is diabetic, we concentrate only on reducing the sugar levels. We don't concentrate on why the diabetic happened, whether the patient was stressed, whether he has other issues, lifestyle issues, all that we don't concentrate. That is why we should focus on integrative medicine. Like, we should focus on our native forms of medicine like Ayurveda, Siddha, homeopathy, naturopathy. Naturopathy means it's a drugless form of medicine where we rely on natural methods to heal our body. So all that should be given focus. Next slide, please. So now we all know that God created us. Does anybody have a doubt in it? Okay, at least not here. So God has created us. God gave us food to eat, right? So you think God would not have created medicine when you have an illness? So where do animals, like in the wild, go? Do they have a hospital of their own? Pets have, because we have created, right? Do animals go to hospitals? So whenever birds have injury, what do? They will lick. Or whenever animals have an injury, they lick the wounded part. Do you know why they do so? Saliva has what? Yes, saliva has antibodies called IgA. Saliva has antiseptics. So when you lick saliva, when you lick with saliva, the saliva will heal the wound. It removes the infection and stimulates the body to heal faster. That is why animals do that. And you have seen, anybody has dogs at home? Have you seen that when the dog, yeah, you have dog at home. When it has digestive problem, it goes and eats grass. Have you seen it? Yeah, so all kinds of natural things it will eat, like grass. Because when it's a digestive problem, it knows that when you eat grass, that fiber will improve the bowel movement and eliminate the waste. But when we have diarrhea, what we do? We put medicine to stop the diarrhea, have everything inside and create infection, and it will go to fever, it will go to all sorts of other problems. So whenever we have an illness, we just turn to English medicine, but we do not understand that God who has created this earth, God who has created us food, will also would have created medicines. For example, penicillin, you all know, right? So penicillin is obtained from where? Fungi. Fungi is from the nature, right? Now, and where is the malarial medicine obtained from? From the bark of a chinchona tree, right? So penicillin, aspirin, all the drugs which we have today, all the medicines which we have today, the sources would have been from a plant or an animal. It is just that we create synthetic analogs. We create them chemically in the laboratory and use it as medicine. So we forget that the essence is from the nature. So always turn to nature. Whenever you have an illness, you can take English medicine. We are not stopping you from taking English medicine. But find out that it just treats the symptoms. So go with integration with nature. Follow certain lifestyle modifications. Follow certain food habits from the nature so that you get healed. You don't get treated, you get what? Healed. So, but why do we have to live naturally? Again, why do we have to live naturally? So, this first modern factory was in 1769. You know how this processed food or canned food started? So, I will take just 30 more seconds. Why was actually everything packed? Why they started packing food?
To make it store it.
Store it for whom mainly? of the military troops. Actually, during the World War only, mostly before, when there were wars, especially the French war in the 19th century, which means in the 1800s, that time only they started packing food for the armies. Then finally we got it very easily, that packed food is so easy, so we all have turned to packed foods. So this is, what is the first packed food company in India? It's called Parle. Now we know it's Parle, it's called Baroda Bottling Company. And in the last 200 years only we have got factories. The last 200 years only we have got factories. Next slide, please. So what has happened? One more time. So in the last 200 years, when we started relying on processed food, packed food, then simultaneously lifestyle diseases like diabetes have increased how many fold? 250%. 250%. So much is the problems which have come due to processed food. That is why we are asking you to live naturally. And now you all are now seeing, right? What is a lot of heart attacks in what, old people or young people?
Yeah.
Especially in the 35 to 40 years. It is due to the unhealthy lifestyle habits, unhealthy food, the medicines we take without even thinking why we are taking. So all of this has been due to the result of processed food and factories. So anything which goes through a factory and comes out, it's actually unhealthy. Because what they use? They use preservatives to improve the shelf life. If you get milk from cow, okay, it gets spoiled easily, right? You have to use it that day itself. But the packet milk you can use for 2 or 3 days, right? So because anything which goes inside the factory and comes out, it will have preservatives and other compounds, and that is why it makes it unhealthy. So what we say is, in this course we will focus on grandma tips. The grandma tips which you all would know but maybe would have forgotten. So it will be like a refresher on grandma tips, Pati Vaidyam they say in Tamil. So to live with nature, leading a life with nature. So that is going to be this course. So today's take home is, try to reduce what? Processed food. What are all processed foods? Can somebody tell? Chips.
Biscuits.
Canned drinks.
Canned drinks, even rice,
carbonated
drinks, rice,
flavored drinks,
all the dal we use, all the powders, masala powders we use, right? Masala also we used to make at home, right, earlier. Now we buy, no, from shops. Noodles, pasta, pizza, all our favorite, no? Burger. Very favorite things, what to do, but they are all processed. Okay? So all those favorite things everybody will like, because they are these taste enhancers and flavor enhancers. If you ask me, I will also like, but consciously we should try to avoid. Consciously we should try to avoid. We will see more in the remaining classes. So any doubts, we can take 1 or 2 questions. Yes, so it's just complete. So, namaste everyone. Thank you.